Hey guys, this is Ivan with Overlook ENT, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to use the anvil. Bam! Alright, so I'm in a, what is it? Backup of my LP, and I'm on creative, look, I'm flying. Alright, basically because I need to be able to pull out books and show you all this junk. Alright, so we have the anvil. It takes iron, a lot of iron to make it. What is it, I think 3 blocks, and then some ingots. I'm sure you'll figure it out, but it takes quite a bit of iron. So, what does it do? It can repair items, it can rename items, and it can combine items, and it can add enchantments to items. So, we'll start with the sword. Keep in mind that there is a maximum of 4 enchantments that can be thrown on any item. So, for example, my sword is pretty beat up, okay? It takes the equivalent of the sword or tool. So, for example, this is diamond. I need diamonds to simply repair it, okay? And it's 25% per diamond, or per iron ingot, or per gold. So in this case, look at that, enchantment cost right here, 32. I throw another one in, 38. It's almost all the way healed. So let me just full-blown repair it. It cost me 3 diamonds, completely repaired, and it's done. Now what I'm able to do is I'm able to rename the item. So, you can call it whatever you want. Let's see. I don't know if it... I mean, I'm sure it doesn't make a difference with characters or anything like that. I think just the simple act of renaming it. We're going to call it the D. Alright, it would cost me 35 XP to enchant it into the D. So, let's do it. So, again, you're able to use enchanted books. Basically, enchanted books are a way to stockpile enchantments. You know, let's say you're going crazy at an Enderman farm and you don't want to enchant a specific item, you can just start throwing it on enchanted books. Basically, to enchant the book, all you need is a book, like so. You enchant it based on the levels. It's just like any tool or armor piece or anything like that. You drop it in here, it'll give you a random enchantment. Let's go with 24. Knockback 2. Alright, this sword already has knockback 2. Now, one thing, keep in mind that if you're in creative, it will let you enchant anything with anything. So in this case, I can throw on my sword. I only have 3 enchantments. I have room for another one. I can throw respiration on a sword, which is completely pointless. In survival, it doesn't let you do that. If the enchantment is not, you know, correlated with the tool or the armor piece, it just won't let you do that. So, okay, I have knockback 2. Let's try for something else. Let's get another book in here. Come on, we'll just go with a good 30. Unbreaking 3. Alright, cannot throw that on my sword. Alright, so forget that. Just know that you can get up to 4 enchantments on a specific item, all of which will cost you XP to do. You're able to repair the item, let's go with that. You're able to repair an item with another item. So for example, let's say I want to repair, these two are pretty beat up. Efficiency 4, Unbreaking 3. And efficiency 3, Unbreaking 3, Silk Touch 1. So, this has more to gain from being repaired. And since this would be the target, it will retain its enchantments and possibly gain something from this one. Though the only thing that it could potentially gain would be efficiency. So, let's do this instead. Fortune 2, efficiency. Okay. Alright, let's do this. We'll try to throw a Fortune 2 efficiency pick on this one, and it would gain absolutely nothing from it, though we would have a brand new pick. Keep in mind that the state of the tool itself also makes a difference. For example, this is beat up, this one's almost broken, so you're gaining some life on it, but not that much. You see that? It's not there, and it's 30 enchantment level, so what you're doing at least is combining it. And you can tell from this one and this one that this one gained absolutely nothing. So we'll just do it. Alright, beyond that, let's see, what else? Yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. If you're using gold, use gold ingots. If you're using iron, use iron ingots. The anvil takes damage, so over time you're gonna need a new anvil. I don't believe there's a way to repair it. So again, you're able to repair items with the item itself. Oh, another big thing. You are not able to repair things like bows. in the sense that you can't throw string and sticks in here, okay? So what you would need to do is actually you would have to have another bow and then throw it in there. So let me, where's my bow? Did I pick it back up? Where are you? Oh, there it is. So basically what this is doing, I threw in another bow and it just went ahead and repaired it. So it's retaining all of its, you know, enchantments, but you need a another bow to repair a bow. Same thing with shears. So it costs enchantments. Granted, this isn't much to make, but 25 levels to basically fix that tiny sliver there. All right, and that is, yeah, that is basically it. So you can enchant for books. You can store enchantments on books. One thing, and I don't know if it actually will work here. I'm not 100% sure on this. Can you enchant the book with a book? Yeah, unless this is a creative thing, then you could. Granted, these combined enchantments make no sense, but even on the PC, I get enchantments that make no sense. Like, you know, something for a fishing rod and, you know, blast protection or smite. So, who knows? Who knows? But seems to be a thing, though. So you should be able to combine books with other books, again, at a cost of enchantment. Fantastic. Well, I hope you guys liked the videos. Always subscribe up top, and peace out.